America, you know, really has an excellent foundation in ingenuity and innovation, right? I mean, it's part of our national fiber. I mean, it goes back to the founding fathers, but you can look at every aspect of technology development in our country and find key innovations driven by entrepreneurs.
Innovation's an incredible asset that permeates every aspect of how we live our modern lives, from electricity to vehicles to the internet. America's really been a global leader in making all of those things happen.
Transforming energy technology does not happen overnight. We recognize that it's a long-term problem.
We have a pretty good idea of a lot of the barriers that we face. The problem is that it's very difficult for these early stage innovators and inventors to be able to actually move their technology forward, and that's where ARPA-E can help.
ARPA-E catalyzes solutions. We're working with the best entrepreneurs and innovators across the U.S., bringing them together to take the best technologies and move them forward to solve today's energy problems.
I'm so optimistic because we have amazing resources in this country. It's the people, it's the universities, it's the companies, it's the national labs, it's the shared user facilities.
The infrastructure and R&D for energy technology is there. We just have to tap it.
We see innovators come from startup companies in Silicon Valley. We see research institutions from the Midwest. I'm from the South, and when I get to go back home to Georgia and work with teams close to my hometown, that makes me really excited.
We ask ourselves every day, if it works, will it matter? We understand that to have an impact, these technologies have to move out to the marketplace, and to do that, they've got to be cost competitive, and they have to outperform today's technology solutions.
Although we've only been around for 8 years, we've already seen some signs of success. We've seen dozens of companies spin out from universities. We've had over $1 billion in private sector follow-on funding. We've had dozens of products start to get into the marketplace.
Along the way, ARPA-E is tackling some of the biggest challenges in energy today. We're reducing our reliance on foreign energy sources, we're building resiliency within the grid, and we're trying to create clean, affordable energy for everyone.
Commercializing energy technology is really freaking hard, but that's why we're here, and there's a lot more to be done. ARPA-E is one of the only places that's still invested in these entrepreneurs and innovators.
It's a huge ambition, it's also an inspiring one, and I love the role that ARPA-E plays in helping to accomplish that.
What inspires me are people who really had nothing and took a risk to make something happen.
Building off the great innovators of the past, the U.S. can and will lead energy technology development in the future. We owe it to our future generations to do that.